communication seemed to be a big word, tying different levels of the organization together. Do you have to change the level of sophistication in communication, say, when you're dealing with a player on an everyday basis, or maybe a coach, or maybe a front office executive?
Absolutely, and it's about that communication. It's about understanding your audience, right? If a coach doesn't understand a complex concept or statistic, you need to be able to simplify it for them so they understand it and buy into it and utilize it. Conversations that I have with different parts of the organization, whether it's player development, whether it's the other baseball operations staff, our coaching staff, our analysts, it varies, you know what I mean? And we have a tremendous support staff, especially at the major league level, that are equipped to help our coaches and our players. Guys like Brett Weber that have been here for years, who's our director of advanced scouting and coaching assistant. He's also our instant replay guy. Dan Payne, our video coordinator. Zach Firo. That they need to be successful.
Right? You're in that clubhouse a lot. It's clear Brian Cashman really trusts your opinion. You haven't been with the organization all that long. How have you been able to gain Cashman's trust so quickly?
Sure, it's a little bit of opportunity, but it's also about versatility. You know, we have a very robust organization and various departments. We call it often a well-oiled machine, but there's always these new resources out there, technology, and trying to implement that into a well-oiled machine takes time, you know? So being versatile and trying to figure out how different new pieces of information can add to the equation is something that we're always trying to evaluate. So always trying to take those new information, those new pieces that are out there and adding it into what we do and try to make better, smarter decisions year in and year out.
Matt, earlier you mentioned job seekers, and for the people who have never been to the winter meetings, there are young men and young women armed with resumes, and they want your job, they want my job, they want Bob's job, and we all have a lot of respect for what they are trying to accomplish.
Sure.
Once upon a time, you were one of those job seekers. Tell us your personal story and what compelled you to go to the winter meetings and how it worked out.
Yeah, I knew I always wanted to work in baseball. I wasn't very good a player in college. I played for a year, wasn't very good, but I focused my efforts in trying to break into the industry from that point forward. I went to the winter meetings twice and met with teams. It was a lot of preparation. It wasn't just show up and work the lobby. You had to email a lot of folks, send resumes, do projects, trying to write my own scouting reports, just show my worth to an organization or show why I could provide value. And that was very successful for me. And I still meet with a lot of job seekers. I do a lot of interviews, and we're always trying to find those folks that are passionate, energetic, want to break in this industry and want to make a career out of this. And there's more and more job seekers every year. It's a very difficult industry, and there's a lot of sacrifice. But I can say for my personal self, I've enjoyed every minute of the opportunities that I've been given. But it's also, putting in a lot of hard work, long days, early mornings, late nights, and the grind of a season. We're in every day, morning and night with home games, road games. And then the off season doesn't stop either. We're here. We're always going to different conferences or different events to try to, again, find that competitive edge to continue to be, the New York Yankees and be the best that we can possibly be.
Well, it's definitely paid off. Look forward to what's happening in 2019. Matt, thanks for joining us.
Thank you, guys.